Good morning all. So myself Venkata Swami. Okay, so I'm a faculty in electrical department. So I joined this particular Christ University in the year 2014. So from that point onwards, I was handling so many subjects. Okay, so for you, I'll be handling a course called Advanced Computer Programming. So I think you have undergone a course on computer programming in the first semester. So this is a new course what we have introduced in this particular semester. So and we coined this particular course as a Advanced Computer Programming. Okay, so what we are expecting, so there is a gap. So after finishing this particular computer programming course, so there is no linkage for you people to, the programming aspects. So to fill that particular gap, so we introduced this particular course, Advanced Computer Programming. And the department felt that, programming skill is essential for all the people, especially for electrical students, it is most essential. So that is the reason why we have introduced this particular course, and we made it a mandatory course in your syllabus. So that is the motive of introducing this particular course. So this course detail in I summarize the course detail in this particular slide. So as you can see, so the timetable is already given to you. Okay, so I'll be taking say 30 minutes synchronous mode and 30 minutes the offline work. So synchronous teaching will I'll be demonstrating. I'll be telling on the theoretical aspects, and I'll be demonstrating some things to you, and then you have to take up in the offline mode the remaining part. So the whole idea, if you see, you have to clearly understand the course outcome. It is very important, and also you have to understand the cognitive level of this particular course. Okay, so the course outcome you can see here. So we have, we will be using Python programming, and the objective is, say, for example, after your graduation. Okay, so many, you have to compete with many people. So who may be very, skilled in some programming languages. So you have to compete with all those people. So that is one of the motive. Okay. So for that, you have to understand a lot of concepts in computer science engineering. So, and also you have to practice, the programming, concept using some programming language. So now we will be using C. It is impossible to cover whatever the computer science engineering is covering in 4 years. So now what we are doing, we made it as a capsules, and entire concept we are trying to feed you in this particular course. So end to end, most of the concept in the computer science engineering is covered in this particular course. So now if you take up this particular course with a positive spirit, then definitely you can compete with the computer science engineers. So that is the whole idea of this particular course. So your cooperation, your offline work, positive move in this particular subject is most essential. Okay, so cognitive level, of course, I just you have to understand, you should have some programming skill, you should demonstrate. Okay, you should create something. Okay, so you have to go to the next level, you have to develop something. So all those skills we have to attain in this particular course. So now with that, I'll go to the syllabus. So now you see here, you have a 5 units. First unit is Python programming. Second unit is Python libraries and packages, and the third unit is data access and graphical user interface. Fourth unit is web and mobile programming. And fifth unit is cloud computing. So these are the units. Now, how the course will go? So I will giving sessions, okay, online session to you. Okay, simultaneously, you'll be having some offline sessions. So you have to go through these sessions, and also I'll give you some activities. And after learning all those things, you have to take up some quizzes and some activities you have to take up. So that will be evaluated. So that is the whole idea. So basically, you'll be having synchronous sessions material and asynchronous session material. Using that, I will create a quizzes. Okay. So every class will be having a quiz at random time. So say for example, I can stop my presentation. I can give you the link and I'll ask you to take up the test. So that is how it will be done. So, and also simultaneously, it will be evaluated. It will not be any consolidated exams for you. So it will be quizzes, okay, practice activities and capstone project. So capstone project is basically, say for example, if somebody want to develop something, okay. So this capstone project is divided into, 5 units. So in the first unit, you define what exactly problem you want to do. Then in the second unit, you just do some, literature survey, already existing things. Okay, all those knowledge you attain. And then the third unit, you try to implement like that, So in every unit, a part of capstone project you will be taking up. At the end of this particular course, you will be developing one big project. Okay, you will be developing your one big project. So it will be individual project, and definitely whatever you are interested, that kind of projects you can take up. So it as per your interest, the subject will sink. So when it comes to online platform, we have to learn lot of tools. Okay, so I'll be using Moodle, okay, Google Meet, okay, and WebEx. And a lot of programming tools are there. Say for example, I need to demonstrate a lot of programs to you. Okay, you have to collaboratively, you have to work with me. So you need to write a program on the other side. Now I have to see your program. You have to see my program. I have to correct your program. So this kind of collaborative learning will happen in this particular course. So for that, a lot of online tools are there. So I'll be giving this particular presentation. And also I'll give you time to explore these online tools. So using these tools, what we can do, we can, collaboratively we can work. So if you got any error, I can clear that particular error there itself. So in that way, we are going to learn this particular course. So I'll be using all those tools. Okay, then the session things I already told. Today's session, this is what we are going to learn. So we're going to learn in a basic sense. So what exactly this computer science domain? So that is what we want to learn. And also the learning outcome is basically you should say for example, what essential skill you should have to compete with the computer engineer. Okay, so that means a lot of things are there. Okay, meet any computer science engineer, and when you make a conversation, a lot of terminologies they will coin. When you attend any exams, okay, so it may be some placement exams, or it may be some higher studies. If you want to attend any interviews, many people will ask many questions, so you have to familiar with some terminologies, and also you should be in a position to converse, okay, with that particular opponent person. So that is the whole idea. And also see tools are very important. So what I have to install, okay, so if I install this particular tool, what happens? So when I have to install MATLAB, when I have to install Python, so when, what I have to use. So many things are there. It's like what I can say, it's like a human body. Okay, if you say a computer engineer, okay, it's like a human body. So many components one should know. Say for example, one should know programming language, that may be one hand. Somebody should know database, that is other hand. So when a person learns all most of the component, then only he is a complete person. Otherwise you can see person, if he knows only programming language, it's only one hand, nothing else. Okay, it's not a complete, is not complete. So that is the kind of, you know, abstract visualization what you can make. So that's why, you know, you should understand the available tools in the market. Okay, so that is one thing what you have to know. And also, you know, I will give you some offline videos, and also I'll give you survey questions in this particular sessions. So try. Okay, so now as you know, yesterday our you know beloved HOD sir told some do's and don'ts. So you have to you know follow online class etiquette, and you have to maintain the academic integrity, and try to mute your microphone so that you know we will be recording all the videos. Okay, I'll be giving all the videos to you, so that you know whenever you refer this particular video at later stages, so it should not have any you know noise disturbance or something like that. Okay, so ask any questions in a window. Okay, I'll be happy to you know answer all your queries. Okay, maybe at the end of the sessions or in between also, if it is most relevant to the topic, I will you know take up the question and you know answer. Okay, try to don't distract the class at any so utilize this particular process. You have to utilize me and you know whatever capabilities I have. So you have to inherit whatever capabilities you have. So I will try to inherit. It is like you know learning together. So no, frankly I'll tell you, I learned lot of things from the students. Okay, so all those things I have to convey. Okay, so this is the platform where I can convey all my learnings to you. Okay, so it you know we have to utilize, you have to utilize, so that you know you will you know definitely compete with the other. That is the whole idea. Okay, so now before starting, you know, I would like to take up some questions from the students. So till now we discussed something, you know, can anybody say something on this? Unmute yourself and just to speak for 1 minute. Ashwin Abraham, can you unmute your mic and you understood what I'm trying to convey?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I see the importance of learning Python. It's a thing that I've been trying to learn as well. But honestly, because of how vast is available materials, it's hard to know where to start from. So I feel that this course will help guide us in the right direction.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your follow-up. Okay. So unmute your microphone. So. Good. Okay, so now that is what. Okay, so now here I just want to you know show you some technology. What you just now Abraham said, like you know what exactly we have to learn, where to start, what to learn. Okay, so this is the question comes. See, and also here the caution is, say for example, you know when you meet a computer science student, they'll be saying lot of things. So in you know what categories we have, what categories of components we have in computer science, what we have to learn. So this is what we have to understand. So yesterday I was conducting one interview. A candidate is elected for electrical engineering. I asked him, why you selected electrical engineering? He answered very beautifully that, sir, computer science, you know, will evolve every day. It will change. New technologies will keep on coming in a computer science. Whereas when I take electrical science, okay, if I learn some concept, that is it. Okay, so that is you know, forever it will be useful. So now the thing is, you are learning the computer science engineering, so it will be you know. It will be useful for you forever, and all the theoretical concept never changes. Okay, so and other side, the computer technologies, it will evolve every day. The changes will happen. So now the thing is how to cope up. Okay, what to learn. Okay, so now the thing is, you are an electrical engineer. Lot of demand is there. Okay, so lot of you know in our electrical domain, lot of things are not automated. Okay, so we have to automate that one. So the only possible technologies what we have is computer technologies or digital technologies. We have to take up that one. So as an electrical engineer, you have to learn electrical concept thoroughly. Okay, that will be useful for you forever. And the other side, you have to learn the computer technologies as well, so that you can automate the electrical system. Okay, so entire electrical system you can automate. Okay, so that is the whole idea. Now the thing is, I always say, okay, the computer science engineers knows all computer technologies. If he tries to understand the electrical concept, okay, you cannot compete with him, because he knows the technologies, he also knows the electrical technologies. So that is why you have to learn computer science concept. When you learn computer science concept, he cannot get into your business. So your job market, or the electrical students can have a very stable life. Okay, so with respect to career. So that is what I say, learn electrical, learn computer technologies as well. It will be most useful, and it will create a very competitive profile. Okay, so that is the whole idea. Okay, so now the thing is, you see here, computer technologies, what exactly? Now just now he said where to start and what to learn. So you see here, some basic things are there, because I spend a lot of time in programming, lot of automation, things I'll do, lot of, I spend most of my time in computer tools. Okay, so I normally apply all those computer tools in electrical domain. Okay, so in that regard, I just classified this one. Now you see, computer technologies means first one, what you should know is programming language. Okay, so can anybody tell any programming languages available in market? Any one person can unmute and say, please.
Sir, C++, Java, Python, then Oracle, many more of this.
Yeah, yes, okay. Any other person? Any other person, apart from this programming, any other programming language? Please, you have to voluntarily, you have to come. And so I already said we have to learn together. Yeah. Programming languages available in market.
So MATLAB. So,
yes, MATLAB.
Swift.
Yes. Okay.
Fortran, COBOL.
COBOL. Okay, Fortran, COBOL. Okay. All these things are programming languages, but somebody said Oracle. Oracle is not a programming language. Okay. So see, when it comes to programming language, you have at least thousands of programming languages available in market. Thousands of programming language. Now the thing is, see, 10 years back, Java was the top. Then earlier it was C++, then Java, then now it is Python. So nowadays JavaScript programming is getting popular. Okay, we don't know. Now at programming languages will keep on coming, and Go programming is coming. So programming language itself, new programming languages will come. Thousands of programming languages are there. Definitely it is good that what we are taking is Python, which is popular programming language, and there are some benefits are there. But you should also understand that there are so many other programming languages also there. Okay, so that is about programming language. So one should know what are the programming languages you have and which programming languages we have to take. That we will discuss. Second component, programming language, you should know. Second component is database. So can anybody name some database?
Firebase,
very good. Firebase. Then, please. You can also put it in the comment box also. If you are unable to speak, you can put it in the comment box also. Databases. Okay. So I'll tell you some. He said Firebase database. There are many other databases are there. Say, for example, your Excel is also one kind of database. Okay. So you are putting data in some particular fashion. Okay. Excel is also a database. And there are some databases are available in market, like MySQL, okay, Microsoft SQL, okay, DB2 from IBM, and say Postgres SQL and no MongoDB. So like this, there are plenty of databases are available. Some you can install in your machine, some you can install in server, some cloud database is also available. So that is about database. So programming language alone will not work. So when you write a program, it has to connect with some data. Okay, so where the programming language will interact, it will interact with the database. So this is mostly, there are these two components are most important in computer science domain. So you should know programming language, you should know database. Because your after writing program, it has to connect to some data. So that's why database also you have to learn. Okay, so what is at Firebase? Firebase is basically online database. It is basically Google provides that particular database. So try to we will explore all those things. Database is also one component what you have to learn. Okay, so data and database. The third one is server. Okay, so can anybody tell what is server? Server. See, I don't want exact definition. See, it is general term we have to use. Server.
Stores information.
Which stores information. Very good. Say, server is basically, it's a remote computer. It's like a remote computer. Say, Christ University has a server. Okay, every organization has a server. It is like some computer kept at remote place. Okay, other person can interact with that particular server. See, I want to access Christ University website. Where that Christ University website is available? It is available in the server. Okay, server, they will put that particular program application in the server. That application is running so that I can see that christuniversity.in. Okay, so basically server is a remote machine where the programs will run and the other person, client, can use that particular application available in the server. So that is one thing what you have to understand. Next one is cloud computing. Can anybody tell, have you come across this particular cloud computing any other time? Cloud computing, can anybody say something? It stores data. Yeah, very good, very good. Any other point?
So data connect to different.
Yes. Please.
So you can connect to different computers in a network that are associated to each other.
So you can connect to different?
Computers that are associated to each other through the cloud. You can this and such.
Very good, very good, very good.
Information can be accessed in any device.
Information can be accessed from any device. Yes, yes.
So it's a network of remote servers.
It is network of remote server. Very good point. Very good point. Yes. Any other point? Okay, great, great. Now you see, most of you knows this cloud computing. As somebody said, it is a network of servers. Okay, it is a network of computers. Okay, it is actually the correct term. So now the thing is, this cloud computing, say Christ University has a server. Instead of going for server, I can have a cloud services. Cloud service is nothing but what you can imagine. It is something like you can purchase a computer from cloud platforms. I can purchase hardware, I can purchase storage. Somebody said I can store data, I can purchase hard disk, I can purchase bandwidth, I can purchase some softwares. Okay, it is basically interconnection of the computers and different services are available. Okay, database as a service, okay, infrastructure as a service, software as a service. Like this, so many services are available in the cloud. So now for you, okay, you have to know cloud computing because in future, everything will be on cloud. Okay, your MATLAB will be on cloud, your Word will be, actually your Google Doc or Google Spreadsheet, all applications are kept in cloud only. So everything will be in cloud. In future, you will not be installing any software in your machine. Everything will be, hosted in a cloud platform. Okay, so pay as you go, like kind of option provides in that particular cloud computing. We will understand that particular. That is also one thing what we have to understand. Cloud computing, algorithms. So a computer engineer should know algorithms. Algorithms, it can be machine learning. Okay, it can be neural network. It can be any other optimization techniques, or it can be some step by step process. So for everything, one should write a algorithm. So whatever you take up, any machine learning is also some kind of function. Okay, somebody written that particular algorithm. So like that. So there are many algorithms are available in market. So we should aware of that those popular algorithms, okay, popular tools. So then only fuzzy logic. So that is also some kind of algorithm. So all these tools we have to understand. So that is basically in a primitive level, that is basically algorithms. Okay. So next one is operating system. Okay. Can anybody tell what is operating system? I mean, sorry. Can you name some operating system?
So Windows,
very good. Windows.
OS.
Web OS, very good. Then
Linux,
very good. Linux.
Mac.
Okay. Mac OS. Okay. So now you see
Android.
Android is also OS. Okay. Very good. Now you see if you see operating system, Linux, Windows, and Mac is for desktop, and other operating systems are basically derived, say Ubuntu, okay, Red Hat, and all those things are Linux distributions. Okay, so Linux, Windows, and Mac operating system. So now the thing is, so people are started migrating towards Linux. Okay, so Windows they are using, we all use Windows, but everywhere they are moving to Linux. So the major block what our student face, because of the lack of operating system knowledge, many things stops. Okay, so that's why we should know how to operate, how to do some minimum things in operating system. So how to operate Linux, okay, so how to operate Windows, how to operate Mac. So those things we have to understand. So then only we can build, we can develop some application. So that's why operating system also one should know. So mobile operating system, as somebody said, okay, iOS, Android, okay, all those things are basically mobile operating systems. So developing application on those platform, or understanding the operating system itself. So all those things, if you want to do, then you have to know the operating system very well. So we will learn few things on operating system also. Okay, because I written Python program, what I do? So I have to run. So how to run Python programming in Windows? Question. Okay, how to run Python programming in Linux? Okay, that is also a question. So all those we have to address. Say for example, a person knows Python, you don't know how to run in Linux, what is the use? Okay, so in that sense, operating system is also essential. Okay, so whenever you go to some job, okay, so they'll be using some Linux operating system. So you won't get that kind of confidence in the workplace if you don't know something primitive. So that's why if you know some basic things, then from that point onwards you can take up and you can learn anything. Okay, so that is the whole idea. Operating system also you should know. The next one is hardware. Okay, so hardware, so can you name some hardware programming, any one person hardware programming?
Arduino.
Very good, very good. Okay, Arduino is also hardware programming, where you do use something like C programming, and actually you will be copying that program into the microcontroller memory, and you are running. So it's a hardware programming. Very good. Any other programming?
Sir, Raspberry Pi. Sir,
Raspberry Pi.
Very good, very good. So Raspberry Pi, single board computer. Okay, you'll be using some hardware platform, microprocessor, microcontroller you'll use, and you run your program in that particular hardware platform. That is also most important. Say, because software should not stop at the soft platform. It has to go to hardware. As an electrical engineer, okay, we have to connect all our programs to hardware. So otherwise, there is no meaning in learning any programming languages or any other tools. So it has to go to hardware. That's why we should know hardware also. So I written Python program, how to load that Python program to energy meter, how to load that program to electric vehicle. So all those things are there. Okay, so that's why one should know some knowledge on the microprocessor, microcontroller, single board computer, okay, system on a chip, okay, all these things we should have some basic idea. So in and I think you will be undergoing some microprocessor, microcontroller programming. All those things will help you connect in this particular way. Okay, so that is hardware programming. The next one is IoT technologies or digital twins. IoT is basically is emerging nowadays. Okay, it is basically Internet of Things. Okay, so we have different domains. Okay, so it's end to end actually. So from hardware to the analytics. Okay, it covers. Okay, so it is a bidirectional. They use internet as a communication platform. So in any domain you can build any application using IoT. I can automate my system using IoT. I can introduce some intelligence in electric vehicle using IoT. Okay, that kind of using IoT in any domain, you can automate that particular task. So few things on IoT also we should understand. So these are the basic primitive component in programming, computer technologies. Now what I request, okay, so time is getting over already, 2 minutes I crossed. I request you to in computer science, let us map that particular things to one of the component. Okay, so I will ask Amrita, can you name any one component in computer engineering? Yes, any one component in computer science engineering? Anything what you heard in computer science?
Programming, C++.
Okay, C++. Any other component? Okay, C, C++, that comes under the programming languages. Any other things you learned, heard in computer science? What electrical student is not aware of, something like that? Okay, great. Aniket Verma? Programming language, you should know what is operating system, how to work on the operating system. Hacking is a process where you write a program in some operating system and you connect to some databases, you connect to some application and you get into their system. So operating system is required. Okay, programming languages are required. You should know the how database works. So then only you can hack. So hacking covers these three components. Yeah, good. So Anujit, can you come in and say one component?
Yes, sir.
Any one component in computer science? Anything, whatever comes to your mind.
Computer graphics.
Computer graphics. Okay. So computer graphics, again, it is something like, displaying some pixels in a screen. It is basically embedded system. So you have something called GPUs. Okay, so it is mainly used for giving the graphics output. So you want to display picture, you want to display video, you want to display game content. So GPUs are there. So using that GPU, you can you can broadcast graphics content. Okay, so again, embedded platform also required to do that particular graphics. Okay, GPU is useful. Yeah, great. Ashwin Abraham, can you name any one component?
data.
Yes, come again.
Databases.
I already said that one. That is a main category. So any other term?
Networks.
So yeah, so network is basically communication, correct? Okay, so normally communication will not come under the computer technologies, that will come under the electronics and communication, correct? So there are many communications are there, wired communication, wireless communication, say example Wi-Fi, internet, all those things are, you know, communication. So one should know, okay, if you want to learn how communication network works, so basically they'll use something called computer networks. Okay, so using that particular computer networks will be as part of your operating system. It will be in a server. So you'll be interacting with different computers using that particular communication. Yeah, so communication is also important. Yeah, good. So, Jnanadhar?
Yes, sir, firewall.
Firewall. Okay, it's basically the subcomponent in the operating system or in the cloud platform or in the server. Okay, so basically they will block some port. So unauthorized entry from other person will be blocked using the firewall. It is basically protection given to operating system. One simple component in an operating system, server or cloud platform. Yeah, very good. Hari?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, any one component in the computer science?
Sir, computer hard softwares.
Computer?
Softwares.
Softwares. Okay, yeah, good. Computer software. Software will sit on top of operating system. Software will sit on top of cloud platform. Computer can sit on top of server. Okay, on all these places you can keep your software. Okay. So it's basically using programming language, you prepare a software. So programming language will be useful to create a software. So programming language, and you are keeping all these things on this platform. Okay, very good. Softwares. Yeah, anyway, fine, great. So now the thing is, anything you heard in the computer science domain, try to map to this one. So let us have the discussion. Let us have discussion. Whatever you heard in the computer science domain, so you just map to this. Okay, if you have any doubt, we can discuss on that. Okay. If anybody have any question, I'm happy to answer to your queries. Any person having any kind of query, you can ask.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, great. Yes, Shreyans, come on.
Sir, how can you include AI into IoT?
AI into IoT. See, IoT is basically cloud application. Okay, so it will reside in a cloud. So when you are you are keeping your application in a cloud, means cloud platform also provides. See, AI is also some program. So that program you are running in a cloud platform. So it is, there are some infrastructure operating system available in cloud. We have to take a operating system from the cloud. We have to keep this particular AI program in that particular operating system. We have to run. Then what happens? You connect your application with that particular AI program. Then your work is done. So IoT is also a cloud application. Especially most of the IoT platform provides the provision for some analytics works. So your AI will go and it will sit in that particular, platform as a service. It will sit on that particular platform you are running. So that is how we get you can connect this AI to the IoT platform. I can demonstrate what you are asking for. So in future, we will connect this IoT and AI techniques. That is also possible. We will do one demonstration in coming future.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Any other question? Please be interactive. I know I took 10 minutes more, but Let it be. It, since it is a first class, okay, let us spend.
What about the attendance?
So this will be automatically taken. Okay, so I have a list. You know, your list is available with me. Okay, so I'll be logging that particular attendance, you know, in my system. If anybody is not you know, connecting or interacting, so even though your name will be there, okay, I may have to exclude. Okay, please be attentive, and you know, you have to be interactive. So if you don't have any question, shall we close? Okay.
Will we have any lab, sir? Office?
Yes.